I don't even hide.
He easily gets a lot of friends. Good to see you, Ambassador.
He's a good ambassador, yeah, by the way.
No, he is. He's very good. And you, Ambassador, have not the easiest job in town, huh?
Thank you. This is why we need your support.
I don't understand.
Do you mind speaking to me just briefly? Or?
Yeah, sure. Thank you. I saw you on Russia today.
Thank you.
Yeah.
So, what is the message that Syria has to the world? When you see the reports coming out about this convoy and they're blaming either Russia or Syria, what happened?
Our main message is that we are fed up. Enough is enough. We need a genuine partners from the whole world combating terrorists. Some people are hypocrites because they pretend on one hand fighting the terrorists, but on the other hand they are backing them on one hand. This is number one. Number two, the same people are saying that their main enemy is President Assad, not Daesh, not ISIL. Then you cannot combat ISIL when you say that, because you are hypocrites. You are not addressing the main issue. Third point, you have nothing to do with who should rule over Syria. The Syrian people should decide who should rule over them. The Syrian people will not decide who should be the successor of Obama in the United States. So we are the ones who will decide. This is democracy. If they believe in democracy, this is democracy. The fourth point is that we have 101 member states out of 193 member states in the United Nations exporting to us their own terrorist garbage. These terrorist garbage are not opposition. They are mercenaries and foreigners. They are coming to kill our own people with the Saudi money, the Turkish training, the American backing, the Qatari money, etc., etc. So enough is enough. The mask has fallen and we are fed up. No justification to anybody while accusing us of doing anything wrong. Now, we are not doing anything wrong. We are defending our country by all the means, legal means.
Now, you heard the statement from this general who said about basically that a no-fly zone would require going to war with Syria and Russia. I mean,
this is blah, blah, blah. This is nonsense. It will not fly. They know, the generals, they know that it will not fly. The Americans, diplomats as well as military, are trying to justify their wrongdoings in their zone by saying, you know what, we made a mistake in bombing your soldiers in Deir ez-Zor, but the Russians also made a mistake in bombing the humanitarian convoy. So they are trying to create a parallel between their own big mistake when they bombed the Syrian military position by pretending that the Russians did the same, on the other hand, bombing the humanitarian convoy, which is not true, by the way, which is not true, yeah. Because there are no holes on the ground. The convoys were not bombed. There are no holes on the ground. And we are doing our own national investigation to know who did it. And we will share it with the UN. But again and again and again, the American administration is not genuine. It's not a genuine broker. And they don't have the will to respect the terms of reference of their own agreement with the Russians. Washington was not even able to respect the terms of reference for 7 days. 7 days of cessation of hostilities, they couldn't hold it because they don't have the political will. They are pretending that, you know what, we cannot separate the terrorists of al-Nusra Front from the other so-called moderate opposition. This is ridiculous. If you cannot separate these terrorists from those terrorists, then don't pretend that you want to make a cessation of hostilities decision for 7 days.